हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज हम लॉन्गिट्यूडनल वाइब्रेशन ऑफ बीम स्टडी करेंगे। देखिए, लेट मी कंसीडर ए बीम। हमने एक बीम कंसीडर की, ठीक है। ये हमारे पास बीम है इनफाइनाइट लेंथ की। लेट मी कंसीडर ए सेक्शन। ये मैंने एक सेक्शन कंसीडर किया एट ए डिस्टेंस एक्स फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट। इट इज दिस सेक्शन इज एक्स डिस्टेंस अवे फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट एंड द थिकनेस ऑफ दिस सेक्शन इज डी एक्स। नाउ वी नो due to longitudinal force along the axis of the beam, a force P is applied here. It means P plus my del P upon my del X is applied here. For the length of dx, the force will increase. Now, and due to this, this element will slightly move to this side. It means this portion, this point will move to this and this point move to this, and we can say it is moving u distance from the initial point and u plus my del u upon my del x into my dx distance from final point. Now as we know, if I draw this stress here, I am drawing the force. If I draw shear stress here, then I can write here stress sigma acting here and sigma plus me del sigma plus me del sigma upon my del x into my dx will act in this side. So simple it is. Let me explain one more time. Here is force P. Here is P plus me del P upon my del x into my dx. If I writing stress instead of force, then I can write stress sigma here in this side and sigma plus my del sigma upon my del x into my dx in this side. Now, from the Newton's law, net force in this side is sigma into my A. A will be the cross section area. A will be the, let me write, A will be the cross section area. Here cross section area. Minus my sigma upon my A, because this side is negative side and this side is positive side. Plus my sigma plus my del sigma upon my del x into my dx into my A. Area of cross section is same for this side and this side. That's why I multiply by area. This will be the net force acting on this element. According to Newton's law, this force will be equal to mass into ma, mass into acceleration, and mass can be written as density into volume. Volume can be written as area of cross section into my the length of the section. Length of the section here it is dx. Here it is dx into my mass. Here this term will be equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration can be write as del u upon my del t square. Here the displacement is u and acceleration is double integral of displacement. So we can write del square u upon my del t square. It is clear. Let me explain one more time. The net force on the section. Here stress is sigma. In this direction stress is sigma. In this direction stress is sigma plus my del sigma upon my del x into my ds. When we multiply by the cross section area, it will become force. In this direction, the net force will be sigma into my area plus my sigma plus my del sigma upon my del x into my dx into my area. It will be the net force. According to Newton's law, this force will be equal to mass into my acceleration. Mass can be written as density into my volume. Volume can be written as area into my length. Area of cross section into my length. Area of cross section here it is A and the length of this section is dx. And the displacement of this and acceleration can be written as the displacement square upon my del t square. Here the displacement of this section and this element is u, as it is clear from the figure. So it can be written as del u upon my del t square. Now, on solving, it can be cancelled out. This is negative term, this is positive term. Area dx dx. Now we get Now we have del sigma upon my del x. Del sigma upon my del x should be equal to rho del square u upon my del t square. It is our first equation. Very simple it is. It is our first equation. Now from the Hooke's law, we can know stress is equal to 1 E into E. Stress is strain and modulus of elasticity. And strain can be written as, this term can be written as change in length upon my original length. So we can write it as sigma. As we know, change in length will be equal to del u. And the original length of this section from the figure is dx. Du by dx. Now from this, it is the value of sigma. Putting this value in this equation, we get, ये सिग्मा की वैल्यू मैं इस इक्वेशन में पुट करूंगा तो देखिए डेल बटे में डेल एक्स इनटू वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा इज सिग्मा डेल यू अपॉन में डेल एक्स इक्वल टू रो डेल स्क्वायर यू अपॉन में डेल टी स्क्वायर. इट कैन बी रिटन एज ई डेल स्क्वायर यू अपॉन में डेल एक्स स्क्वायर इक्वल टू रो डेल स्क्वायर यू अपॉन में डेल टी स्क्वायर. Or simply we can write it E bate mein rho, this rho is in this side, E bate mein rho del u upon mein del x square equal to del e square u upon mein del t square, del square u upon mein del t square. This term can be written as c square del square u upon mein del x square equal to del square u upon my del t square. Here the value of c equal to under root of e by rho. It is known as velocity of propagation. Now the solution of this equation has two functions. We can say the solution of this function is x into my t, xt will depend upon the x and also depend upon the time. When we considering the time function, the solution will be equal to a sine omega t plus may b cos omega t. So simple it is. If it is only the function of t, then we can write it, the solution of this equation will be a sine omega t plus may b cos omega t. But it is also a function of x. So we can introduce the solution with respect to x. It is very simple. C1 sine omega. Here t, but here x by c plus me c2 cos omega x by c. Very simple it is. Now how I write this term here, when I am writing that t term, very simple it is, a sine omega t, the coefficient is here 1, so divided by 1, plus my b cos omega, here the coefficient is 1, so divided by 1. But in case of x, c1 sine omega, very simple t, in case of t here it is x, so sine omega x, here it is x c square, so we are divided c divided by c. In similar manner, agar dekhiye yahan pe jo bhi term hai usse hame divide karna hai, jo square ki term usse divide karna hai square ko hata ke. Yahan pe kuch nahi tha to humne 1 se divide kiya to niche likhne ki requirement nahi padi. But in this case here we are writing x c square, so when we are going to write the solution with respect to x, then we have to divide it by c. It is the solution. Now this function, it is the function of time, so we can say it is the function of gt and it is the function of x. So it is our solution of this equation equal to uxt equal to gt plus my ft. Now it is the final solution of our derivation. So simple it is. I think It is very clear to all of you. If you like it, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.